I want you to ask me, technology and humans, the relationship between both, is it getting out of hand? Facts! Yes, it is. Nika? So basically, you have people getting up in the morning. They're not even getting up. They're laying in the bed. They're laying in the bed. They're turning over to the nightstand. Not the lover. The nightstand. Picking up the phone and seeing how many likes they have on the picture they posted the night before. Instead of turning over to their lover, kissing them on the cheek. And maybe you just laying there enjoying the moment, planning out the day. Is it to a point our new companion is the telephone, the cell phone, the digital device, digisexual? Since the iPhone came out, sex with men has gone down 30%. It's kind of hard to compete with the phone. It's challenging. Technology provides an option to where you don't have to face regular reality and put up with being bored or just cherishing the moment. Like, if you put down the phone or whatever, computer, tablet, then you would actually come back to you. It may seem bored for a second, and then you start remembering you have a voice. I think that social media has become the voice in our head, the new voice in our head, telling us what to do. And if not telling us, at least it's becoming the motivator of why we do things subconsciously. It's the voice. Instead of our voice, instead of listening to us, start listening to so many things around us, you know, it gets that our natural voice inside of us gets drowned out. It just becomes a quiet muffle. And social media and the media become a loud voice, impactful. It's to the point to where you don't even know what's going on with you anymore. Are we really driven off of our own desires, or have our desires been taken out and replaced with what makes sense to corporate so we can actually abide by their agenda? And it's not a conspiracy type of thing. It's more of what, like, from the psychologist's point of view that are creating these apps and creating the technology, it's more of like, what can we do to keep them wanting more and more and more, you know? And inadvertently, it's taking us away from ourselves, because the more that we want, then the farther away we get from us. Because we start thinking we become happy when we have outside things and outside influences and outside material, opposed to, you know what makes me happy is in here. It's in here. It's inside of me. Everything else is an added-on bonus. That's cream. That's the cherry on top. Everything else. We can't define ourselves by the material things, but we have to define ourselves by our own integrity. And then everything that comes outside of that is an add-on. It's like the spinners on your car. You know, you don't get the spinners and you say, fuck the car. Or you get a Honda and you put spinners on the car. Now, I don't even think they put spinners on anything anymore, but I'm just giving an example. It's like you're adding on to things that you don't have to add on to. You're adding on things that's too premature to add on to, you know? So if you get money and you have a mentality of somebody that's broke, like if you win the lottery, but you never had money before, you're gonna fucking spend it because you haven't done the work on yourself to actually know how to preserve that money and make it multiply. You just know how to spend, spend, spend. So unless you educate yourself, this shit's gone. You hear about it all the time, all the time. Man, I just went to the fucking liquor store. And they won the jackpot, $750,000. How long are they going to keep it? I don't know. But you know what I do know? It's Valentine's Day, and you need to go find somebody you love and fuck them. Do you realize there's a dude in China that just married a hologram? There's a woman that just married a plane, a Boeing 747. Sex dolls. That industry is going up. I mean, the fake flesh seems to be what the men are choosing. I mean, since the sex has gone down between men and women, it's crazy. What else? I think there's somebody that wants to marry a robot. It's called digisexual. Digisexual. Digital. It's not sapio. It's not bi. It's digisexual. There's some people that do not prefer the touch of flesh. They only want to be compassionate with a device. Anything that you can plug a USB into is what they're interested in. So imagine coming home one day and bringing your significant other, and they just become attracted to your iPad, and they're just like, it just turns them on. No more you, you're expired. That's what's happening to humanity. The last bond holding us together is the intimacy that we share with each other. And once that gets taken away, what do you think happens? No more humanity. You've seen the movies. It's not anything that's like hard to figure out. It's normal. It's the normal process of things. People think the technology is more than what it is. It's just a supplement. A supplement for attention. You know? But anyways, happy Valentine's. Go enjoy your time with a significant other. No matter what you're doing, as long as you're together, have fun, love each other. And you know what? Don't be a digisexual. Don't do it. It's not worth it. In the end, they're gonna get burnt out. Big facts.